Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. This time I want to work on another winter landscape image on which I want to apply a very dark and very moody style. For the editing I will be using Adobe Photoshop and probably also make use of the Nik Collection plugin. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. And since I'm using Photoshop, I'm in the Camera Raw editor right here, and the first thing I want to do is to check the lens corrections real quick, then go back to the basic stuff. Right away I want to change the profile to Adobe Landscape, since this will give me some more base saturation. For the temperature I think I want to go with something like this, and then start to balance the exposure. But I don't think there's actually much to do, but I want to boost the contrast quite a lot actually. And for this image I think I dropped the vibrance quite a lot. And then let's increase the saturation. And the reason I'm doing this is, this way the colors get muted a little bit, and by increasing the saturation, the contrast of those colors will be increased slightly. It's kind of hard to explain, but I hope that makes sense. Then let's start doing the local adjustments. I want to start by using gradiated filters first. And you can see I have applied two of those right there. Let's start with the foreground first. And I kind of want to play around with the light in the field right there. That means I want to have a strong contrast between the darks and the highlights in this field. And for the very near foreground, I want it to be a lot darker. So let's first drop the exposure. Then let's go to the upper gradiated filter. And again, here I just want to drop the exposure slightly. Okay. Next, I also have applied two radial filters. Again, I want to start in the foreground, and I'm using this radial filter to give this whole field a little bit more detail. And I'm doing this by increasing the clarity. And I can also add some texture for some extra sharpness. Alright, then let's jump to the other radial filter. This area I actually want to brighten up a little bit and maybe give it a fake fog look, and for this I can simply use negative dehaze, which will brighten up this area. To make everything a little softer inside here, I'm also dropping the texture. And that's it for the local adjustments. Now it already looks much better. Then let's continue doing the color grading. For this image I'm skipping the HSL adjustments and go straight to the split toning. And I really only want to work on the shadows by giving them a blue color cast. So let's increase the hue. And let's add some saturation. Okay. Now for a little more color grading I can go to the calibration tab and just play around with those sliders right there. In this case, I'm turning down the red primary hue all the way, as well as the green primary hue. To be honest, I'm just doing this because I think it looks good. I actually don't know what's happening when I play around with those sliders, so sorry for that. But I think that's it for the color grading, at least in the Camera Raw adjustments. I still want to sharpen the image real quick. And then let's open it. Okay, first I need to crop the image a little bit. I don't want to have that much sky included. Oh, I think something like this looks much better. Then I want to clean up the whole thing. Therefore I'm using the spot healing brush. And just paint over things I don't want to have included. Okay, then next I want to do a little dodging and burning. And for this, I want to specifically target certain bright or dark areas. And for this, I'm going to be using luminosity masks. And for this reason, I'm using the TK panel plugin, which allows me to easily create those luminosity masks. So first off, I want to duplicate this layer by hitting Ctrl J. And then I'm creating the luminosity mask using the TK rapid mask. Here I'm activating the layer mask settings. And as I want to first target the highlights, I'm choosing one of those lights masks. When I alt click on the layer mask, you can actually see which luminosity range is affected by it. So if I go with the first lights mask, quite a lot will be affected. In this case, I'm going with the second lights mask. Now I'm switching the blending mode of this layer with the luminosity mask to overlay. Then I'm creating a new layer. Create a clipping mask by holding down the Alt key and clicking between those two layers. And now when I pick up the brush tool with a bright color and a reduced brush opacity, I can carefully paint in there and only really affect the highlights. Okay, and I want to do the same thing for the darker areas. So again, let's duplicate that layer and drag it all the way to the top. Then again, I'm going to the rapid mask panel. And instead of the lights, I'm going with the darks. And again, I think I'm going with the second darks mask. Now again, here the white areas are the ones affected by this layer. So let's create another new layer, switch the blending mode to overlay again, create a clipping layer, pick up the brush tool, and this time set the foreground color to black. And maybe let's drop the opacity a little more, and then start to darken some areas here. Okay, I think that looks pretty cool. Now I want to merge all those layers I just have created, and I'm doing this by selecting them all and hitting Ctrl E. Of course, this is a very, very destructive workflow. Instead, I just could have selected them all and create a smart object out of them. But I'm just used to the other way. So anyway, let's check the Nick collection for some final effects. And first off, I want to give this image more of a blue color cast. Therefore, I'm using the Brilliance Warmth filter. And instead of adding warmth, I'm just dropping it. Okay. That looks much better already. Now I also want to apply a dreamy look. So let's head to the Nick collection one more time. And this time, of course, I'm going with the classical soft focus. And here I'm choosing the second soft focus preset. Okay. And that's it for editing this dreamy, dark winter landscape image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.